Hello, everybody. Welcome to Cigar Review TV. I'm the host, Damon Pettit, and this is the cigar. Let's see if I can show it to y'all a little bit better. This is the Big Payback, and it's a Room 101 cigar. And it's the whole Matt Booth. He's got a very successful jewelry thing, line. It's more than just jewelry, it's a whole accessory thing. Pretty incredible, actually. But tried to get some information on his, on the different cigars, all the, you know, the tobacco and everything involved. But when you click on the website, when you click on cigars, there's absolutely nothing happens. So there's a broken link for his cigar, I think, for the cigar part of it. And which is, I don't know, kind of a bummer. I was hoping to get some information, so I tweeted him, hoping maybe he'd see it. Apparently he didn't, or he didn't care. It's probably like, yeah, another review, great. But, I didn't realize how nice and fat this baby was. Very weird. When I was first lighting this thing up, it had a reminder taste to me of mustard, like a mustard seed. Very weird. I don't think I've ever had that before. And it's weird because I'm not a big mustard guy. I'll throw some on a sandwich now and then, and on a bratwurst. And that's usually about all I'll do with mustard. I don't eat hot dogs that often, just because I know how they're made, so it doesn't really thrill me to have one of those. But I'm going to go ahead and pair it with just a regular coffee. I went to, I'm in Old Scottsdale, by the way, right now, and I was doing a Meerkat thing, and I'm actually doing Meerkat right now, and I did it a little earlier, right when I first got down here, and went around this area where they have these dance clubs. It is so loud, so I recorded that, so I might put that in right at the beginning or something like that, and then, so you would have already, if I end up putting it in there, you'll see it, because it'll already be in there, you would have already seen it, all that shit. So anyway, we'll find out if I put it in there or not. Either way, it's a really, really loud corner. Actually, a loud couple blocks, kind of like that car that just went by. But it's like, it's hard to explain. It's very loud. And because right, this little part of Old Town that I'm in, very artsy, a lot of, you know, a lot of shops to shop at, a lot of places to eat at. And then right over there, dance club heaven. It's freaking crazy. So not sure there's a problem with this cigar. Nice. Swear to God, if I'm gonna have to start a different review, I will do that. Doesn't feel like I'm getting okay. Seems like it's there seems to be a flaw in this cigar somewhere, but we'll see. We'll see how it smokes. A little peppery right now, right on the tongue. The draw is a little bit on the shitty side, unfortunately, so far. We'll see if that cleans up. I cut it okay. My cutter is kind of one of those cutters where you can't fuck it up too much because it only lets you go in that much. So that should be all right. I know it's properly humidified. I just bought it yesterday. And luckily it was only like $5.50. So if it is messed up, then so be it. Actually tastes really good right now. And see it lighten up a little bit. No. Okay. Okay, maybe it's I hadn't had a bigger cigar for a while, so maybe that's part of it. I'm out of practice on the big ones. That's really not what I want to say, I think, but you know. It does have a decent aroma. It's nice that way. I'm hoping I like this. This guy, Matt Booth, he's very interesting character as far as somebody in the cigar world. And I think we see more and more of the different people in the cigar world, like Drew from Drew Estates, stuff like that. You can look them up or whatever, but if you don't want to, you want to know my thoughts about how this guy is. If you could build somebody out, like if you could make everybody into a jar of powder, and then you want to build somebody, which would be kind of weird, but if you could do that, you'd probably take like a cup. I don't know, let me see. Yeah, like a cup of, trying to think of somebody. Of Avo. Can't really pronounce his last name very well. But, cup of Avo. He's a incredibly talented man, been in cigar world forever, makes fantastic cigars. I'm not sure as far as Room 101, as far as how he'll, you know, I don't know if this is a huge passion for him, but it's definitely something that he does, obviously. So just a cup of Avo, and I'd say 3 heaping cups of Robert Downey Jr., and if you've seen this guy lately, I think you know what I mean. He's got a lot of personality. He's very, very personable. He's very entertaining. Very Hollywood. Seems to be very Hollywood-like. And then maybe another cup or 2 cups of, what's his name? Oh, come on. Shit. Another 2 cups of just probably level of Jesse Ventura. And only reason why I say that is because he's a Jesse Ventura is a you know, was in the military, supports ideas of, you know, he's a very, very smart man, by the way, Jesse Ventura. But anyway, so you put all that together, you mix it up, and this guy pops out. It's kind of my opinion on not knowing him, only seeing some interviews with him, and the kind of thing. He's very, holy cow. very good at what he does, as far as definitely for his jewelry and stuff. So far, the cigar, it gave me a little bit of that small rough patch. I don't know, maybe there was just a little something that needed burn through or whatever in there, but it's very beautiful out here tonight. We've had weather go from the high 90s like a week and a half ago to like the mid to high 70s. And now, lately, in the last few days, we've been in the 80s. That's from, some kind of motorcycle. He's got his music turned up. That's cool. I don't know if you can hear that or not. Maybe you can. Bad part about that is now there's going to be music on my on the thing, and YouTube will probably mute it or something. This cigar, right now it's okay. Like I said, it's $5.50. It might have been $5.95, so it's right at about $6. And I, so I figured, what the hell, you know? Can't really go wrong with $6. You gotta be shitting me, right? It doesn't matter. I actually like music. It sounds like at least it's decent music. But I already gave you the weather report, so that's good. We got the weather report out of the way. Always have to mention the weather, you know. I know in Colorado, I was talking to my dad today. He said that it snowed there this week. I saw that in the weather, on the news, where there's quite a few accidents. And that always happens this time of year out there. You know, everybody starts getting ready for spring to really kick in, and then there's a snowstorm. And then you get people that just really aren't ready for the snow. And it piles up everywhere, and accidents everywhere, all that kind of shit. Little motorcycle guy went away, if you couldn't tell. It's got quite a bit of flavor. Now I'm more into a, I don't know. Kind of some reminders of, like, almost, it's a nice car, of little hint of some cherry in there. This is not a flavored cigar in any way. This is what the flavors kind of come out to me. And kind of berry-ish, a berry taste. It's a very, very thick ring gauge. I think it's a 60 ring gauge. So that's thicker. There's some people that smoke some real, I mean, there are some really, really, really thick ring gauges on cigars now. And kind of like, I almost want to try one, but I haven't been able to bring myself to get one of those yet. One, I don't know when I can get a block of like 3 hours to smoke a cigar. And then, I don't know, it'd be kind of uncomfortable at the same time. So. The cigar world is really, really kind of getting interesting, I think. We have, you know, all the classic old cigars out there that are very great, you know, like I already mentioned Abbo and stuff like that, but Good night, Mark. I am doing doing Meerkat, and have a couple people every now and then are saying hello. This cigar, though, definitely, I was a little bit afraid right at the beginning. Still smoking it, obviously, but it's smoking good now. It's not bad when you can get a, you can buy a cigar for $6 and it actually turned out to be pretty decent, and so far it is. I've got a little bit of time for this to go down, but I don't foresee it dying on me or falling apart in any way. It's definitely a bigger ring gauge, one that I'm not, I'm usually smoking a ring gauge around in the 50s, 52, depending, you know, obviously always depending, 58 a lot, I guess, that I can, you know, think of. I always like to drink something with a cigar. Sometimes my mouth can get really dry when I'm smoking a cigar, and that helps. Plus, it just helps to break up the different flavors. It will obviously enhance some flavors of the cigar, and it might even hide other flavors. So you got to remember that when you're drinking something with a cigar, it's gonna affect it differently. My last review, I actually even had a piece of chocolate, and that really changed the taste of the cigar. It was, I don't usually eat anything with my cigar, but I was really, really wanted that chocolate, so. Smoked them pretty good. Again, I'm here downtown, not downtown, Old Scottsdale, and this is the little artsy, the art area, a lot of galleries right through here, and I don't know, it's a decent place to kind of hang out, and it's really odd, because just probably a quarter of a mile away, there's all these dance clubs, and it's pretty, and there's some sports bars, that kind of thing, so there's a lot of people out there, really loud, already mentioned that, but anyway, I try not to, I'm not a big news guy, but I do end up seeing news here and there, which I never end up liking it. But, luckily, this week I really haven't seen any bad news, you know, any really horrific news. I'm sure there is some out there, but. Somebody in Meerkat just asked me if I wanted to recommend a cigar for somebody who always has one. And there's quite a few, honestly. You don't have to get like really expensive cigars in order to please somebody who smokes cigars. There's a wide range of really good ones. Some of my favorites are going to be an Ezra Zion cigar. I have other reviews on, you know, on my website and on YouTube or whatever. You can see how that's, see what those even look like or whatever. And then got Avo cigars, which I'm a pretty big fan of those. Those are ones that are always going to please somebody. And the Heritage cigar for Avo, it's an Avo Heritage cigar. That's one definitely that you can... I'd be surprised if somebody who always had a cigar, they would like that cigar. I'm almost 100% sure about that. You can look at CAO cigars. My favorite there are the Brasilia cigar. And then the other one I would recommend that I like a lot are Ashton cigars. But the sun-grown Ashtons, those are my favorite as far as the Ashton cigars. There's so many out there, but those are, I think, some that pop into my mind. But the Ezra Zion cigar, pretty high on the list there. They're a boutique cigar, which means, you know, you're not gonna, they're not like a Macanudo, and you know, Macanudo has, you know, owned by General Cigar and this whole thing. Ezra Zion cigars, very, you know, they make limited amounts or whatever, and so they're not, you want to go to their website to see a cigar in your area. You could even tweet them. I'm sure they direct you on where you could go in your area. So that's a question right there. Answered. It's the first question I've ever had live, I think. At least doing Meerkat, so it's pretty... I appreciate that. Actually, one of the people from Ezra Zion is going to be out here. I wish I didn't have to have these. Never used to have to, and then all of a sudden, one day, I was working, and this is like a really shitty switch got switched, and crapped all over my eyes. Really sucked. I'm glad I was able to help. There's, you know, tons of people out there. They have their different opinions on the different cigars and stuff like that. So that'll be that's my opinion on them, and on the ones that I like the most. So, and I'm sure that there will be tons more coming up that I keep learning. Like this one so far is pleasing. It's a very inexpensive cigar, and which honestly, to be honest with you, with the world of the 101, what is it, room 101, it's really, I don't know, I think they have some really high end jewelry, but then I think they have, you know, also affordable jewelry. I actually saw a ring on their website, the Room 101 website, and I thought it'd be kind of interesting. I have a friend that really, really cigar, like, if he was just going to go buy a cigar for himself and go smoke one, it would probably be an Avo cigar. And this Room 101, they have an Avo ring, and I thought, you know, maybe I'll look to see That thing was like $2,500, so, you know. I like my friend a lot, but come on. No, I said... It just really depends on everybody's different taste and bank account and everything else. But like I said, if you know somebody, if you want to get somebody a cigar or cigars as a gift at any time, and they smoke a lot of cigars, and you walk into a shop and somebody is showing you cigars that are like 15, 20, 30 bucks a stick, whatever it is, you don't have to sit there with that. Keep moving on. And yeah, it was a ring. Somebody just asked another question. It was a ring that was $2,500. So that was it was right around there, because I thought I was gonna possibly look to get it for him, but not the, like I said, I wasn't gonna marry the guy, just my friend. But like I was saying, if you end up wanting to get somebody a cigar, don't be talked into a high-end, high-priced cigar. Though there's a lot of great ones out there that are high-priced, and you can really, you know, get some real nice ones and pay some, you know, like I said, 20 bucks a stick on up. But it's not something you have to do. You can just, have people walking around. More than likely, might be a couple of drunk people. But they, what was I saying? Oh, as far as the cigar thing goes, getting somebody a cigar, you can get a really nice cigar anywhere from $6 on up. And the best thing to do nowadays, one of the best things to do is you can like search Twitter for cigar, you know, cigar whatever. Somebody who likes cigars, and if you can see that they smoke cigars a lot or whatever, you can ask them, tweet them. You can find a weirdo like me that's on Meerkat or has a thing on YouTube and ask somebody like that, and then you could go into the cigar store and, you know, say, hey, ask them the same question, and they might, if it's a good store, you could tell them the price range that you're looking for, and, you know, what your friend likes, that kind of thing, and more than likely, they're going to get you a good cigar, so... So it's very, you know, like I said, there's something else that's also, oh. Felt like that thing was going to go out, but it seems like it's okay. In a way, it's like wine. You can buy $1,000 bottle of wine, and it's going to be really good. It's going to be excellent. You can actually make wine like an investment, stuff like that, because it can really go up in value depending on what it is you got, what you have there. But I've had some not so great high price bottles of wine and some pretty damn good very low price bottles of wine. So it's going to be the same thing with cigars. So, you're very welcome, and, you know, feel free to shoot questions at me anytime. that's the cool part of the whole Meerkat thing. I was always looking for a way to do stuff live. And unfortunately, my schedules only allow me to be, kind of do it this time during, you know, during the night, which, you know, in the eastern side of town, it's, I don't know what time it is right now. What time is it here? 10, so it's like 1:30. Now the question, why do some people just have a cigar hanging out of their mouth and they like chew on it? I'd love to know that, to be honest with you. For a long time I was really into racing, like IndyCar racing. And there's this guy, pretty sure it was, I can't remember if it's Carl Haas or somebody else. I think it might be. But that guy will stick a cigar in his mouth, and he will, but no, obviously, I could just see somebody smoking a cigar in an IndyCar pit and just blow it all up. But I've never seen that guy with a lit cigar in his mouth. It's always, he's just chewing it. Not only does he chew the shit out of it, but it'll turn it around, and then it'll have a chewed end sticking out of his, you know, on the outside, and then it's a little bit much for me. So I'm not exactly sure. I think some people like the taste of the tobacco, just the actual tobacco, and so when they're, you know, sitting there chewing on it, biting on it, they probably get that nicotine, and that'd be too much for me, though. A dean at a law school does that. I could see that. The burn on this cigar is a little wonky, but that's okay. In case anybody that's watching on Meerkat doesn't know, I'm doing a cigar review, and I'm recording it over here, which that goes on YouTube. And it's just one of my things that I do. And so, so if you're wondering why I'm talking over this way, that would be why. But going back to the Room 101 cigar, and I wrote down the name of this cigar is Hueso or something like that, so I'm not exactly sure if that's just the size. I think it is. I think that he named the different sizes different names. And so, like I said, I tried to get information. I went to the site, I looked at other things. I tried to get like blends or whatever. So I always like to, when I can, and when I have time before I'm going to smoke a cigar and do a review on it, I like to, you know, get as much information as I can on it and understand where that's coming from, the art of actually building the cigar. It's, to me, an art form to make cigars, just because so much that goes into it, you know. You have the people at, okay, what kind of blends do we want, you know, sizes, and where do we want to get the tobacco from, and, you know, then I'm sure Obviously, I don't, you know, I'm not a cigar maker, so I don't know the exact things that go into doing it for sure, but they, you know, then they got to test different blends and get them to where they, you know, like their cigar, and then they come out with a certain blend, and, you know, the tobacco is always an aged tobacco, because that's how it all is done, and gets piled up, bundled, and it's just a crazy thing. And then they're hand-rolled by human beings, you know? They're not machine-rolled by a bunch of machines. You got a human being that takes these different things of tobacco, put them on there, well, you know, they do their thing, and then they end up here somewhere, wherever you are. For me, it's here in Arizona, and now I'm smoking it, and so whoever, whoever rolled this cigar, if there was some identification on here, you know, I could say, hey, roller number 77 rolled this cigar, good job, you know. But they are the unsung heroes in the cigar world. Well, I will say, right when this thing started, I was afraid. I thought, shit, there's something wrong with it. It's not going to light right. Caught on just a little after that. It was probably just because I didn't really light it good enough at the beginning or something. And then and it's caught on, and it's been a very decent cigar this whole time. I'm enjoying it. So that's good news. $6 cigar. Well worth the $6, and you know, pretty much you're lighting $6 up and smoking it. So to me, anytime I'm lighting some money up and smoking it, I want it to give me some sort of enjoyment and not be all shitty. So when I don't usually go around buying really expensive cigars, you know, I just don't. If I was a billionaire, I wouldn't be doing that. I'd be smoking the cigars I like. I would try some other cigars. I'd probably buy a, you know, $40 cigar just to give it a try, and probably go, what the fuck? It's no different. Actually, it's even quieter here than I expected it to be on this little corner. This is actually, there's a street that goes down this way, and then there's a roundabout, which then right over here, and I can actually show the Marquette people. First of all, let's turn you around so you don't have to see my face. There's the, see? Yeah. And that's a fountain right there. It's a car going that way. And then another street that goes that way. And so I'm right on this corner. And I expected there to be a few more people. And I'm glad that there's not, because I don't bother anybody. And I don't want them bothering me. Like to just enjoy a cigar, relax. If I'm doing a review when I'm smoking it, then, you know, I like to be able to do that. I don't mind it, though, if people come up and say something, unless I'm being kicked out or something like that. I don't want that to happen. It's a very medium-bodied cigar. One thing here in Old Scottsdale, there are a lot of really expensive cars that seem to go by. Just Maserati I saw, and then I saw Bentley. that, it's a Chevrolet. So a little bit of everybody through here. And it's definitely pretty freaking beautiful out here today. I saw a thing that NASA says I think they said the next 15 years that there will be, should be proof of communication from other solar systems. Now, I'm sure that there are some people who are like, ooh, cool, finally, you know. We've had that stuff going on since before any of us were alive. If you look at all the different artwork from hundreds of years ago, and all the, you know, stuff in Egypt, and all the different, there's been other worlds traveling around for a very long time, visiting this beautiful little planet that we're on. And hopefully this little planet will be able to hold up to all the shit that we're putting it through. The price point on this cigar being $6 is right about right. You know, this is not something I'd be like, oh my god, the best cigar I've ever. It's a good cigar. It's a nice cigar. It's enjoyable. And but like if I didn't know how much it was, I'd say probably in the $6 to $7 range. I would guess it at that. And that's just based on other shit that I've smoked, and I've been smoking cigars for, it's actually a while now, since what, 1996, 97 maybe? Maybe a little longer than that. It's been a while. So I don't know. I've had quite a few. And there are people that have had tons more than me. And apparently there are people out there that when they smoke a cigar, they can taste the soil and say that, oh yeah, I could definitely taste that this is from a Cuban soil. Come on. Maybe people can do that, but I can't, so. And just because I can't doesn't mean that they can't. I know that for sure. I know that there are people out there with palates that can tell you exactly where a wine is from. And I don't know how they do that. My dad can do some things like, you know, he went to a little school thing with that. And I know that there are the master sommeliers that are unbelievable. I don't know. Some pretty incredible stuff out there with your palate. And my palate is definitely not that as refined as others, you know. I eat a lot of different food, but I have not traveled the world yet. Actually, on a Sunday night, this is a good place to come hang out and have a cigar. You got the sound of the water. I even know it's a fountain, you know, man-made fountain. It's just that sound. I like that sound a lot. It's just kind of nice to hang out, relax. Used to always have kind of like some music playing next to me while I'm doing a review. And I don't exactly know how it works out, but if you have something like that playing in a video of yours, and it's on YouTube, and it gets detected at some point, and it's got a certain kind of copyright on it. Frank Sinatra's, by the way. They'll mute the shit out of your video, so. I'm actually, I know that these aren't the best for you, the Frappuccino thing in the bottle, but actually kind of tastes good today. Lots of cars, quite a few cars going by. More than I've seen before, which is fine. It kind of gives me something to stare at, look at. Look at the people looking at me. I'm looking at them, they're looking at me. I'm looking at them, they're looking at me. Hopefully they don't flip me off or anything. No reason to. I'm not a bad guy. Ride my bike a little bit now, a little bit more. Used to ride back and forth to work every day. You know, just kind of not put the wear and tear on my car, that kind of thing. And then after a while, I stopped doing that. Actually, I got sick. I threw up everywhere. It's like over a year ago. And after that happened, I kind of got out of that system. And then I didn't want to riding at 4 o'clock in the morning when it's like, you know, 35 degrees outside. It's not so comfortable, and so I kind of got out of it at that point for a little while. But back into it, rolling with the bike again. I like that, enjoying it. Feels good on the, well, it hurts like hell on the body, but it feels good because it's doing my body some good and kind of back to where I was, at least cardiovascular-wise. And I just need to throw some weights in and do some stuff like that and feel pretty good about myself. Physically, anyway. Mentally, I think I'm just going to be hurting. Speaking of which, if anybody has any pointers for a really hurt area in my neck, I'd like to know. It's just like I don't have full range of motion in my neck anymore. It hurts like hell all the time. It's been like that for like a month. Yeah, it would be nice to get that taken care of. The other day, coming home on my bike, I nearly got hit. I was so close to being hit that I knew I was going to be hit. And I was going across a really busy street, and a car was turning, but they were going through, you know, the little walk thing was going. I usually kind of go against the grain a lot, and, you know, I'm taking chances, but at this point, I was, like, actually following the rules of the road, and I could see the guy's face, and I was trying to think of if I was going to go over this guy's car, or how it was going to end up being, and somehow, it didn't happen. It was really crazy. I really thought, yeah, here we go, this is going to happen. I'm going to get hit by a car. And that's it. And I just kept going and nothing happened. The quietness of a Prius. The electric cars are crazy, huh? Well, I'm going to stay on Meerkat, and I'm going to end the cigar review. More than likely, this Room 101 cigar, the Big Payback, $6 cigar, it's worth a try. If, you know, if you're looking for kind of a little quickie cigar, well, not really quickie, but a cigar that's not gonna break your ass, and you're gonna be able just to enjoy a little cigar if you, you know, go into a poker game or, you know, and go hit the ball on the golf, whatever the hell it is you want to do. If you just want to smoke a cigar, it's worth a try. It really is. It's not definitely, I don't dislike it in any way. It's not like my most favorite cigar I've ever had, but it's a decent cigar. So you give it a try if you want, and let me know if you have tried one, what you thought. If you were going to try it and you try it, let me know what you think when you do. And leave me comments, whatever that you tweet me, whatever the hell you want to do. And if you work for the CIA, you can just come find me and say hi. Hopefully that doesn't happen, because that might freak me out a little bit. But anyway, thank you very much for watching. And I'll be seeing you again real soon.